Okay. Interesting.
So Jordan Peterson says this is not beautiful. Now I have my own opinions in regards to this, but I want to get your guys' opinion, because this does kind of go into the, he says it's not beautiful, which then says it's not sexually beautiful, but this could be a feminine woman. And let's just kind of unwrap this for like a quick minute. What do you guys feel? Bernard, you can go first on this one.
Well, Jordan Peterson saying this is, he said this is not beautiful. That's what he said.
Yes.
Right. Yeah, him saying that, I definitely understand where he's coming from. They're doing the whole fat acceptance movement, and they're trying to tell us what's beautiful. I think a lot of what we perceive as beautiful, I think the majority of it is natural. We're hardwired to see certain things and certain traits and certain attributes as beautiful. Yes, there's some fluctuations throughout culture, but they are on a hard campaign to try to say that even a poorly built, overweight woman can be beautiful. And yeah, I think that's some nonsense. So I do respect him taking a stand on that. Then I'll be remiss if I didn't point out there is a movement that's been going on for a while towards thicker women. I'm one of the few people in this space. I got a full head to toe picture of my woman on my Instagram page. I can see what type of thickness I like. So I do like some thickness, but I ain't messing with no unshapely. nothing unshapely. So if they're trying to sell that, I'm not buying what they're selling. So I respect and I stand with brother Jordan Peterson for taking a stand against it. So I'm with it.
Okay. Tawana, what do you feel?
I think that no one is forcing anyone to believe that someone is beautiful. But
I didn't say force.
Is it my time to talk? Did I interrupt you? Okay.
You got it. I just was saying I didn't say force, but you got it. You got it.
Thank you. No one is forcing anyone to be attracted to anyone. Okay. But people always feel the need to give their unsolicited advice. So let me just say this. Jordan Peterson himself talked about how vicious people can be on Twitter. That was one of his responses. It's why he decided to get off. And he said that people were just like overly critical and whatever. But then he doesn't talk about how he participates in this very thing, right? Because her being beautiful, okay, you can think she's not beautiful, but her weight and how beautiful she is, how does it affect you in your life? If other people find her beautiful, if Sports Illustrated picked her to be on the cover, which they've picked many women who are fit and beautiful, Kim Kardashian was on one recently, right? Like, there's other women that they can select. They have an array of women who are willing to do it, who fit the criteria or whatever we think is beautiful. However, they chose this woman. So the fact that he felt the need to criticize her or call her ugly or say she wasn't beautiful, I don't really get the point. But people were trying to argue it's a health thing and he's promoting all this. But he didn't really say anything about her health or weight. He really just talked about her beauty. And I think that it's ridiculous for you to think that people have to feel like you and everybody thinks that way. No. And I'm sure that there's a reason why Sports Illustrated wanted to put her on the cover. And I don't think that we should be telling people who's beautiful and who isn't, especially when we're in certain spaces. And I think that it's really irresponsible of him. But at the end of the day,
Tawana, let me ask you this, Tawana. Yeah. Do you think we're going to add the last question as we close this out. Do you think that there's some undertone of European cultural prejudgment on this lady? Do you think that he sees thick hips and maybe an unshapely body, and he's making a dog whistle to his followers who are largely white males, that they're trying to make us like thick women? Do you think that he's kind of using that?
I mean, I know he made a comment about like he can't masturbate to that or something like that. I feel that it is this standard of beauty that white men in general, like, and some other races of men try to push on all women, right? But then there are men who are extremely attracted to women who are shaped like her, who look like her, and it's not anything to be ashamed of, and it's not anything to, I guess, shame people for. I think that people need to understand that your beauty standards and what you are attracted to is not necessarily what other people feel is beautiful. So
Bernard, what do you think, Bernard? Yeah. Just on the thing, do you think that this is something that a white man is saying as a dog whistle to his followers in regards to the shape of people of color not being attractive?
No, I don't think it's a dog whistle about people of color. I mean, after all, this was I don't know what her race was.
She's Japanese and Dutch.
Okay. So she's like European and Asian. So no, I think that's a reach to say that he's dog whistling to say that people of color are unattractive if this was a woman who wasn't necessarily a person of color. So no, I don't think that's the case. I just think that, I'll say this. Tawana did say something good at Jordan Peterson, who did make a bold statement about somebody. He did criticize somebody, and was that Sports Illustrated that put it out there? So he's criticizing Sports Illustrated, he's criticizing her, and then people come criticize him. You can't turn into a snowflake and get mad when you get some own criticism. I will give you that that one good point, but this is my overall general point on it. Everything is media advertising. There's a propaganda war, and yeah, whoever puts their ideas, views, thoughts, perspectives, or what they see as beautiful out there and get it out there circulating, that's the person who's not going to make or force somebody to like a fat woman, but they're doing what they want to do to try to, I guess, stir the pot of the culture, to try to lean more people in that direction. So they have the right to do that, and people like Jordan Peterson have a right to just take a stand and say no. They're clearly selling something, and he's clearly saying, I'm not buying what you're selling. So for that reason, no harm, no foul. But yeah, I'll just leave it there.
All right. So, like I said, we can probably debate on that subject by itself. Last time we did the subject, it was 2 hours, and I don't think nobody really got anything resolved. But I think it definitely lies on a couple of opinions.